the motor car or telegraphic wires, when England not just ruled the waves but ruled over our lives. California fever had spread around the globe, a rush to waiting sailing ships, ye travelers all aboard. Destination, a southern nation across the southern seas, a land where rivers gleamed with gold, a land of hope and dreams, where poverty and bitterness could all be left behind. Foreign men with nothing but fortunes yet to find. Someday. In Ballarat on early morn, Eureka days of old, a story true and moving tells of courage I am told. When just a hint of dawn began to spread across the sky, a motley crew of miners took a stand prepared to die. They swore under the Southern Cross to fight for liberty, to stand for justice one and all, and set the nation free. Against all odds, against the laws, oppressive to extreme, the miners swore under the stars and paid in blood to dream. To claim democracy, they cut down every living soul who tried to even flee. Surprised and overrun by forces loyal to the crown, to no avail, the miners stood their ground, most everyone. Among the brave and bleeding, soon to count among the dead, a nameless man with mortal wounds inflicted to his head, had held his pike, had held against king's horses and king's men, had held his pike defiantly right to the bitter end. John, he tried to hold the line with other men of courage who now knew that it was time. As bullet, bayonet and sword who found their chosen mark, as forces loyal to royalty laid siege in morning dark, and as a nameless pikeman lay there dying on the ground, his only friend beside him just a scruffy little hound, who howled and growled at any who did dare to take away his master and a hero who took his final breath that day. Cried out so plaintively, a loyal friend right to the end for God and all to see. He sat upon his master's chest, his howls were heard by all, right on the spot where on that day courageous men did fall. And soon after, John's body had been tossed upon a cart, upon the many who'd been stabbed right through the heart. Man's best friend then leapt aboard, sword, for none could drag away. The dog right by his master's side, a legend born that day, that day, that day. Pikeman's dog again. No one ever named the graves of all the fallen men, most likely put down in cold blood with graveyard digger's spade. The bravest little terrier beside his master's grave. December 3, lest we forget, in 1854, liberty and justice finally made it to our shores. Political decrees of greed, of power and of kings had forced the miners to rebel, a stockade bunkered in that day. That day. When all the stars are spread across the sky, the Southern Cross still shines on all the souls of those who died. In unmarked graves not far from where democracy was born, not far from where they swore an oath of loyalty at dawn. For every little thing we have was fought 4 years ago by those who dared to stand up for the freedoms that we know. What fragments of democracy we boldly call our rights, we owe a debt of gratitude to those who held the pikes that day. Against the tide of apathy and ignorance, the mark of modern times. Some of us remember, shame on those who do forget. Shame on politicians who've not learned the lesson yet. Shame on all the people who don't recognize the flag. It basks in all the glory and the benefits they have. Eureka is our history, don't let it slip away. For once again we're ruled by iron fists, as on that day, that day, that day, that day.